Here we go again, back with more Pro Cycling Manager Season 2015 and Stage 5 of Tour de Romandie. My name is Jürgen Olszu and today we have the most exciting stage probably of the entire Tour de Romandie. Of course this isn't, I believe this isn't the real version of Tour de Romandie, so I don't know if this is an exciting stage in real life, but here in this race is probably the most exciting because we have a Category 2 climb, which is actually pretty long, could probably be a Category 1 climb, a pretty steep Category 1 climb as well, and the final climb up there be. So this could be a really fun stage. We have Froome in the lead by about 2 minutes ahead of Quintana. He is the favorite for the stage as well, Froome. Geraint Thomas also wants the favorites, but I'll probably once again sacrifice Geraint Thomas for the greater good of Chris Froome and the overall victory. But yeah, we'll try and do our best with the entire team. Froome is the captain, so he gets priority over everything if he has a bad day though. So let's get into the race and the final two climbs probably. Last 33 kilometers. And we're into the final two climbs. Cordelis Blanches is already on for the breakaway riders right about now. 10 kilometers long, 9% nervous. That's a sick climb. Puccio is the only rider remaining right now in front. We'll switch him out right now with Nieve and Kwiatkowski. They'll go at around 75 pace. And then we'll put Geraint Thomas on Christopher Froome. Froome will then have to move all the way up to the front now, because this is... Now some of the big riders are going to fall off as well. We have already, I mean, my 4 weeks riders have already managed to make this peloton down to 65 man peloton, and this is pretty incredible because, I mean, Ben Swift could have been up there as well, but he crashed, so that's why he's down here right now. Bit of unfortunate timing for his crash, otherwise he would have probably been in the group up front here. But let's see, we now have Kwiatkowski leading out here, a little bit downhill here, and here starts the climb. Froome on the wheel of Bardet. Pinot has actually been attacking a couple of times as well. He was the first rider to attack in the entire stage on kilometer 1. I don't really know why he's still 7th overall, even though he lost like 3-4 minutes to Froome yesterday's stage. I still don't really get the strategy behind that. Velits moving up, I think, to protect Van Garderen for a while, but for how long Velits can last at this pace, I don't know. He's not that Vuelta 3rd place talent that he was a couple of years ago. So now it's Nieve and Kwiatkowski taking turns up in the front. There's 8 men out in front, a couple of big names as well have gotten away. They just take the 4 riders was probably on 4, Bakerlands, Jungels, and I think Schürzo attacked away. Arredondo and Kieselowski are in the breakaway from the start of the day. So it has been a pretty strong breakaway. Pires has been in the breakaway the entire day as well. He's now soon to be caught by the peloton. Froome is right in the wheel of Quintana right now, sitting perfectly. Kwiatkowski and Nieve leading out in front here now. Still 64, 4 riders in the peloton. Just gone over the toughest part of the climb now. Puccio has been dropped. More riders are about to be as well. Rojas, Pedredo, some Movistar riders, Herrada, Izaguirre, and Anacona. It's good news for me. Amador. Actually, that'll mean if Amador isn't there after this climb, that'll mean Quintana will have to do the final 20 kilometers all by himself. Probably be pretty difficult to drop all 5-6 Movistar riders, but would be a really good help for me because he would have not have any protection at all, and I'll still have Geraint Thomas to protect Christopher Froome here. I would like to go a bit further back because I feel like Geraint Thomas is sitting further up than Kwiatkowski and Nieve, and that's probably not the best sign. I could go solo right now with Froome, and probably Quintana would be the only one able to join me as usual, but I'd rather save my energy for the final climb. You decrease the risk of dying out and Quintana gaining like 5 minutes before you, before the time trial tomorrow, which is the last thing I want to have right now. Kwiatkowski is already dead. Yesterday was the other way around with the Nieve lasting for a long time. It's down to 37 riders now. 13 more riders have fallen off. Rosa again. Navdauskas. Kwiatkowski, one of the next to fall off probably. Sanchez, Latour, Kieselowski, Dombrovski, Willy, Anacona. Amador is still up here. He probably will be for a while as well. Caruso, Reichenbach. That's the last Francis Schuhelber for Thibaut Pinot. But up front, it's still Mikel Nieve, he's now caught Bakerlands. There's still 5 riders out ahead. Chini, Monfort, Tialongo, Arredondo, and Konstantin Ciuccio for Dimension Data. Mike are now attacking. That's an interesting move, honestly. He's 14th overall, hasn't done as well as I expected so far. We could see a move now, but still no real action from any other riders. Amador has fallen off now with Caruso Velez. That's a lot of the helpers here. Bagelands drops straight through. Pinot has been in the breakaway, so I don't think he'll do that well today. Talansky seems to be tired as well on top of that. That's it, I think, for Mikel Nieve. We can auto now. Go back, get some water. Bardet attacking here. Okay, Quintana joined, so I have to be ready now. I can't let this... I can't just let, Quintana go away on the downhill of all places. So we probably have Micah out ahead now, right now, yeah. Only have Genie, Micah and Tialonga out in front now. Monfort, still from the breakaway, has actually just managed to hold a 14 second gap. John Thomas is tired, he struggled, but look at how much energy Chris Froome has left. There's only so few riders in the peloton, and John Thomas has sacrificed himself by sitting in front of Froome the entire stage now. Nieve is still here, that's pretty impressive as well. Witkowski not with the best of days today, sitting down here with riders like Jungels, Dombrovski and Kieselowski, who's been in the breakaway, not the best status for him. He'll have to just hope for the best of the final climb here, which will not be easy climb at all. Not as hard, probably, as the last climb, but still pretty difficult, I would have to say. Okay, putting Nieve back up front here. Is that an attack on the flat from Nairo Quintana here? I had to join it with Froome. I don't want him to see him get away here. I would like myself to be the one to attack first. Plus 5 for Chris Froome as well today. Didn't even notice that at all before now. He's going to absolutely dominate everybody today, I think. Look at that. He's not even struggling following Quintana. Nieves here. Gian Thomas. I could just put Gian Thomas on auto. I know Puig crashed. I don't really care about that. Could just put him on auto here. Did he attack again, or did I just stop following him? Oh well. We're into the final climb pretty soon anyway. You know what, I'm just going to lead out this group here now. Let's just... Yeah, okay, we have already closed the gap up to, what's it called, Quintana. His attack pretty much massively failed. Shinny, Michael, the last two breakaway riders out in the front now. 8 kilometers to the finish line. Froome will now start his solo. This is now going to turn into a time trial for Froome. If you want to follow Froome, you're welcome to, but I would very much not recommend it because Froome is an amazing rider, both time trial and the mountain, so he's probably going to drop you. Gian Thomas and Nieve are going to be dropped here. Let's see. Looks like about 7 riders able to follow. Micah, Juan struggling already. Pinot struggling as well. Quintana, I think it's the Quintana struggling as well. Might not be that visible. Bardet, Van Garderen drop from Bardet Israel, Hissedal, Dumoulin as well. This will be a 3-man group. Oh, Quintana. He's going to be dropped straight from the wheel. Bardet is strong today. Oh, he used a lot of energy trying to get up next to Quintana. Let's see here, 41 seconds, Quintana still trying his best to hang on, but it's going to be difficult. He's getting dropped here. Yeah, that's it. Froome is just completely dominating. Plus 5 day shape, plus excellent condition. I know Quintana's excellent condition as well, but I don't think it's plus 5 in day shape. That's pretty amazing to have on the most important stage of the race. You just get that great of a shape. He's going to win the stage by over a minute, I believe. Just take my energy as well to show that I am dominant enough that I haven't even used Manitil before now. 2 kilometers to the finish line now. Oh, pretty soon here for Christopher Froome. There we go, 2 kilometer mark. 1:25, we can just slow down to 80 as well. Bardet, a 5-man group here fighting for 4th to 8th place, I think it is, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, yeah. Then we have Mollema, Micah Kelderman, Pretty Port. Gian Thomas and Mikel Nieves down here. Gian Thomas, of course, using a lot of energy up the last climb. Dumoulin going away solo for 4th now. He is stronger than everybody else here. Can he get up to Quintana and Bardet to fight for second, third. Doesn't matter for Chris Froome because he's already across the finish line now. He's a kilometer ahead of Quintana. He wins by over 2 minutes. Pretty amazing result here from Christopher Froome. You can see the time still going up and up and up. Dumoulin going fast here at the end, almost getting up with the group with Quintana and Dumoulin. Quintana comes in here, 2:38, I think, after not a few seconds after Bardet. Dumoulin takes fourth, will probably be continue to defend his third overall close with Bardet though, but he'll probably take it at least in the time trial. Pino takes fifth ahead of Bauke Mollema, then Hesedal, Uran, Van Garderen, I think soloed a bit, Richie Port as well soloed up, Olang, Maika, Kellerman for 11th here, Nieve, and John Thomas down here in this group, fighting for, what is it, 15th place, Rui Costa is here as well. That's a bit disappointing for Rui Costa, I think. He was in top 10 before today. He'll probably drop out of top 10 now. Kwiatkowski, not the best of stages. He's sitting here with Bob Jungel still. Villains, Villas, I think it was, and Bui from Quickstep. Quickstep has a terrible team. I mean, why did they pick a team with no climbers at all? I know Quickstep is not really known for having great climbers, but they had to have done something better than this, because this is not great at all. Kwiatkowski will sprint a bit here, gain a few more seconds, maybe be deciding for like 30th or 29th place once we've done the time trial tomorrow, you never know. But that's it for today's dates. The rest will just slowly cross over the finish line. Tomorrow will be the final stage. It's like 20 kilometer long, I think. Time trial, Froome will be the favorite race. The favorite for the time trial in total will probably be Dumoulin. But Froome is in great shape right now. Won 3 stages in a row, so why not win 4 in a row? Check it out tomorrow. If you guys enjoyed it, remember to leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.